how late it is, no matter how long you've waited, you can feel it.
Every time I've been in there, I felt it in that arena. I mean, the first one, there was Bo Dolphy, a complete mismatch. It was still carnage in there that night. Right, then, of course, you know, there was your fight in there where you didn't realise it, and I'm sitting there thinking, well, we're anarchy in the UK comes flaring out. And I'm thinking, wow. I remember I saw you the next day in Times Square. That you remember, I was chatting to you in Times Square the next day, the next morning, and I was saying, I don't even know if you really, I think we were wild in there then. They had the Irish against him from John Duddy
as well.
I was there for Hopkins against Trinidad, and those were vicious fans that night, and Hopkins loved the milk. Just about 10 days after the two planes landed in the Twin Towers, and Don King allowed in hundreds of firemen and servicemen. There were tears running down the aisles. Let's have a little pop over there. The lights are down. The lights are down. There's all sorts of stuff happening. Let's just see in case something grand happens. We've got fantastic jumbotron screens which we need for the basketball. The crowd are getting ready. People have their phones. Miguel Cotto getting close, getting ready, looking very fancy. Now we thought that Cotto was walking in second. That's what we thought. Being introduced first, and Martinez walking in first but being introduced last. It looks like it could be a shift. Hard to tell from that. If Cotto is out, is amongst the crowds, he's definitely walking in first. Unless, of course, they stuck Martinez in the ring. It's a bit of an intrigue. You give someone a little pop on the cheek there. He's getting very close. You can sense it, you can smell it, Michael. I'm just edging towards Martinez. I'm probably making a mistake. I'm just edging towards him. I came in here tonight. If you'd have asked me at 7 o'clock, I think I would have gone Martinez. There he is, Cotto. Heavily tattooed, more so than when he was younger. This should be Sergio Martinez coming to the ring. Won his first world title in 2008. Beat Pavlik for the middleweight title in 2010. And Pavlik looks so big against him. A calm man, he's been injured, he's had injuries, serious injuries. Still using crutches late last year. Not sure if he'd actually ever fight again, to be perfectly honest with you. He decided he would. He's pulled punches out. You saw one there knocking out Phil Williams when he's had to. I just think he's looked a bit heavy on his feet in his last couple of fights. Knocked back with a fluidity. Fouled to make it incredibly difficult for his opponents. It is generally hard to hear. Maybe a little bit overconfident against Martin Mulder and Stavgar. Maybe he felt he didn't have to move that much. There he is, a focused man. If you've been with us since 7 o'clock, thank you so much. You make it a very special place to work, a very special place to be. Even at this time, even at 4:35 in the morning. You know what? Let's go over, let's get a bit of music, let's get a bit of light, let's get the team. And let's enjoy this fight. It's Cotto, it's Martinez, it's Box Nation, it's live from the iconic and spiritual home of boxing, Madison Square Garden.
His trainer says. So not official weight, but 161 for Cotto, 166 for Sergio.
You'd expect him to rehydrate. Good information, Christina Poncha. Glad that you were able to get that.
But Martinez has gone and come a long way on deadly hooks, good looks, and perseverance beyond the normal, even of other prize fighters who come from nowhere to such great glory. didn't start fighting until he was 20 as an amateur, turned pro at 26. Basically felt rejected in his home country of Argentina and moved to Spain, then to California.
From the center of the world for sports and entertainment and the mecca of boxing, Madison Square Garden, New York City, New York, this is the main event of the evening. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBC Middleweight Championship of the World. And it's all brought to you by Mr. Bob Arum's Top Rank Incorporated, Miguel Cotto Promotions, DiBella Entertainment, and Samson Boxing. Sponsored by Tecate Con Carácter and PlayStation, PlayStation 4. Greatness awaits. Sanctioned by the New York State Athletic Commission, Chairperson Melvin Alathan, Supervisor David Berlin, and the World Boxing Council, WBC President Mauricio Suleiman, Supervisor Chuck Williams. The three judges scoring from ringside, from Italy, Guido Cavalieri, from California, USA, Max DeLuca, and from New York, USA, Tom Schreck. And inside the ring, in charge of the action at the bell, referee Michael Griffin. And now, the officials are ready, the fighters are ready. Ladies and gentlemen, damas y caballeros, argentinos y boricuas, estamos listos! For the thousands in attendance here at Madison Square Garden and the millions watching around the world on HBO pay-per-view, ladies and gentlemen, let's get it! Fighting out of the red corner with head trainer Freddie Roach, wearing purple, black, and white. Official weight, 155 pounds. His outstanding professional record stands at 38 victories, including 31 knockouts with four defeats. He's the former light welterweight world champion, former two-time welterweight world champion, and former light middleweight champion of the world, the Carlos Puerto Rico, Miguel Ángel Cotto. And waiting out of the blue corner with his head trainer, Hugo Sarmiento, wearing black with red. His professional record, an outstanding one. 51 victories, including 28 KOs, with only two defeats and two draws. From Quilmes, Buenos Aires, Argentina, the reigning, defending, WBC middleweight champion of the world, Sergio Maravilla.
During his 14-month layoff, Martinez had a personal visit with Pope Francis, the new Pope from Argentina.
All right, so we're set to go here. The hairs are standing up in the back of my neck, anticipating the WBC Middleweight Championship of the World. And I'm sure for the fighters, their hearts are pounding. Here we go. Martinez decked out in the primary white trunks. And you see Cotto with all the tattoos of the purple and black trunks, a little bit of white trim on his trunks as well. Martinez, the southpaw, jabbing with the right hand. See how he starts here. He's got the long shorts on, so you can't see it too well, but he does have knee braces on. On both knees. some leather. All business, both guys, no messing around here whatsoever. Thor tries to test his right hand upstairs, blocked by Martinez. Again, Martinez has a considerable advantage in reach.
And Martinez was hurt by a left foot. And he appears to be wobbling.
He is wobbling, Larry. Cotto trying to get in and see if he can finish this thing off early here. He's definitely wobbled by that hook. Another one to the body. And he's down. The champ is down in round one. It's up to 5 and 6 and 7. So you were right, that hook hurt him more than I thought.
Get on him early and they test his mobility. They test those knees. And he went right at him.
And he hit him again with the left hook.
So Cotto trying to take this guy out early if he possibly can. Freddie said the fourth round. This is round one still. How about that? The right hand gets through. Is it the 39 years of age? Is it the 14-month layup? He got hit again. And he's staggered. He's hurt again. And down he goes. For the second time! Remember, there's no three knockdown rule. The count is up to a standing 8. He takes the 8 count.
45 seconds left. Can he make it through this round?
With 40 seconds, and down he goes again. That's the third knockdown of the round, but as I said, there's no three knockdown rule. He'll get the 8 again. His legs are totally shot. He's trying to get revived, down 3 times in the first round. The crowd absolutely loves it. Still 20 seconds to go. He caught him, put him down again. Left hook again. Martinez hanging on for all he's got. Inside of 10 seconds to go in the first round. Nobody would have dreamed this. Look at this, he's all really, his legs are just not there. And the bell ends the first round. Martinez won't be able to recover.
A 10-6 round, currently, the first round. I haven't seen a 3 knockdown round like it since Pacquiao fought Marquez the first time, and Marquez didn't recover. But Marquez wasn't 39 years old, coming off of operations on his knees and hands and shoulders, and 14 months of inactivity.
Well, there it was. That's that hook that you called, and that started it. And there's the second one he goes down. Christini went to point out a couple of occasions, just totally off balance, legs aren't there.
He's completely flat-footed, even as he's walking out right now.
So here we go to round number 2.
Well, I'm recalling now how he was hurt badly by Chavez, if you recall, in the 12th round, and he fought back valiantly and gamely.
He'll do all he can do, but as he get that kind of stamina, as he get that kind of grip left, he's a hard shot still being landed by Cotto. And he's still very flat-footed in Sergio Martinez.
And Cotto is sort of controlling the middle of the ring. Freddie Rose talked a great deal about this fight, about something I've never heard a trainer talk about ring position.
Ring generalship.
Ring position. Being in the right place in the ring where you can deliver the punches you want to deliver.
Don't get the hands caught up in the ropes. Don't have to slide one way or the other. Be in position. A very good point, and he's got position. Plants himself right in the center of the ring. Let's Martinez do the circling around. This is round 2. Down 3 times in the first round was Sergio Martinez. Can Cotto move up to 160? So far, so good. Just his hands look so much quicker than Sergio right now. Sergio's legs still out there. His knees look like almost like an old man walking around.
Really fragile, right, Carol? His legs look really, really fragile right now.
They really do. And that's causing the flat-footedness, and that causes a lack of balance. And there he goes again. That's not a knockdown. But again, that's weak knees. He shook off the outstretched leg, but he's weak in the knees. There's no question about that in my mind with a minute to go here in round two.
This is exactly what Freddie and Gavin McMillan said. They're going to test his mobility early. I don't think anyone would have predicted three knockdowns, but they got him on his wheels early, and they got him stumbling. Who knows how long those legs are going to hold up?
Now he still looks, what I would say, very loose in the knees right now. And if Freddie wanted a textbook situation for Miguel, he's got it. Because it is Martinez that is doing all the moving, and Cotto is just kind of just lining himself up for these shots. They are testing the legs early of Martinez. Hard shot again, partially blocking the glove by Martinez. Ring generalship is all Cotto as we come to just 10 seconds remaining here in the second round.
The biggest question coming into the fight was answered immediately, wasn't it?
Certainly was, and Cotto wins the second round as well. Miguel Cotto's wife and the son. Five points behind is Martinez. These knockdowns again. That one, again, we called it the slip of the outstretched foot. Now let's see if Martinez looks any better on his legs here in round three.
Well, he's supposed to be the bigger man, the bigger puncher, and yet he's moving so much, he hasn't been able to try to impose his natural advantage, or the one we thought he had. Another quick left hook by Cotto early on.
This is round three. You know it's scheduled for 12. Both fighters have predicted knockouts. And this Martinez going with the left-hand power shot down the middle, but he didn't quite catch Cotto. He looks to be in a better gear, in a better place right now than he has been at any other time during the course of the fight. Trying to get some quick hand movement off, and he comes in and bumps shoulders with Cotto and ties him up. Michael Griffin lets him punch a little bit while they're tied up and then separates them. Martinez trying to take advantage of the reach, but coming right through is Miguel Cotto. Cotto has maybe a thumb that caught him in the eye or something there. As his right eye is blinking. And 40 seconds to go now in round three. Martinez landing a little bit more in this round than he has in the, certainly in the first round and the second round. Cotto trying to get position to land something powerful again. Hands down, and Martinez just inviting trouble.
Finally a little bounce in the step for Martinez in this round.
Well, he's having a decent round this round.
Martinez has an unorthodox style, throws punches from unusual angles because he is so athletic. But Cotto has kept it moving, and it's hard to generate anything powerful while you're moving as much as he has been.
Cotto moved in, couldn't land anything in that quarry there.
And Cotto is being respectful of that fact. He's not getting reckless. Relentless, yes. Reckless, no.
But that's vintage Cotto in the early years, relentless. Martinez takes advantage of that long jab of his. seconds to go in the round. It's the third round. Cotto had Martinez down three times in the first. Won the second round. I think Martinez is outboxing in this round. Closing seconds down to the bell. And that's the bell to end the third round. I thought Martinez came back and won that round myself. Barry, do you agree with me on that one?
Yes, I do. Yes, sir.
Freddie's saying, I don't want you to follow him. Force him into a situation where he get off the left hook.
Take it down, let's go.
I like Freddie in the corner. He gives one or two thoughts to his fighter instead of screaming 17 or 18 instructions, which they pay no attention to anything. But Cotto has it in his mind what he has to do here now, not to chase this guy around. Just try to cut him off. This is round four. Jerome Bob Sheridan, the anchor, Cena Punch, and of course Larry Merchant for the expert analyst here. Our principals, Miguel Cotto. Maroon-colored trunks with black and white on them. And the silver trunks with black trim, Sergio Martinez. Red, of course, around the middle. Well, he's doing what Freddie said. He's trying to cut the ring off instead of following him around.
That's the only way he's going to get that left hook off that did damage in the first. But that's, I think, why the reason that scored the last round for Martinez, because he was able to continue to move around and box, and Cotto wasn't able to land as many punches.
I'm wondering now whether they're turning conventional wisdom on its head, which would have been that the advantage early would have been to Martinez and later to Cotto because of the unknown physical deterioration of Martinez. But here is Cotto.
Heavy blow landed that time. The left hook, and it kind of gets an adrenaline flow because Martinez says, come on, let's go. Well, he does that. He delivers the left hook again, the right hand. Just missed that time with it.
Cotto is just outboxing.
Just outboxing
right now.
Yep.
Beautiful.
Cotto assaults with the left hand again. It shifts Martinez around to his left. But not the kind of power that the ones that landed in the first round.
Martinez does have tremendous power, but it's like if his legs aren't there, which all that power comes from, how effective are those power shots going to be on Miguel Cotto?
Well, that was a question coming in here, and that's what's going to be answered before this is all over. He still, to me, looks wobbly in his knees as the front feet get tied up, which is not unusual for a southpaw or right-handed fighter. Cotto coming in, lands the left hook that time to the body. Cotto almost muscled him that time as Sergio had him tied up. Miguel trying to measure him with that left hook again if he possibly can.
Cotto is the master of the middle of the ring.
He certainly is, and he's the master boxer right now at this point in the fight. Falling short with those left hands, which is the power hand for Martinez. And round four is in the book, sends a Cotto around. .39-34, mostly based on that first round, a 10-6 round. Take a look at the replay here. Miguel tries to go to the body that time. But look at the power and strength that he had when he just muscled him right back that time. Well, you watch, he just spins him around using his strength. So Martinez is supposedly the stronger guy, and Miguel Cotto's showing some pretty good strength in his own right here. So we get ready to go to round number five at Madison Square Garden in New York. Miguel Cotto is out in front of this fight, having knocked Martinez down three times, but unable to finish him in the first round. That kind of set the pace for what's going on in 2, 3, and 4, with Martinez winning the third round and Cotto coming back going boxing in the fourth. This is the early going in round number five.
What does it say about Martinez that he's not willing to stand in with the smaller guy? Cotto started his professional career after the 2000 Olympics as a junior welterweight, 140 pounds. Martinez has been 154, 160 pounder most of his career. And yet he is the one moving out of the way of Cotto.
Almost as if his fight plan was to box and use the long reach and try to land that big left-hand power shot at some stage.
I thought, you know, it was just a year ago that Cotto lost to Austin Trout here, another southpaw, but not this kind of a southpaw, different kind.
Pushing
his punches a little bit because of his movement.
But you know, Larry, even at his best with powerful, I've seen him knock guys down, and yet that left hand looks very awkward. It looks like,
yes,
like he pushes it all the time, yet I've seen him knock guys down with that.
Well, you know, it's because he's got this kind of improvisational boxing style and unusual athleticism. That he's been able to hit fighters with punches they haven't seen. But Cotto seems very much wired into what the possibilities are here.
I like his composure.
46 seconds to go here in the fifth round. The chance for Cotto goes up. Out of 20 seconds in the fifth, Martinez continues to reach, Cotto continues to make it miss. And you're right, Larry, why did he come back out there instead of coming in? Double pumps with the right hand, misses with the left. Cotto lands some solid shots. How you scoring that round, my friend?
I gave it to Cotto.
I gave it a Cotto as well, but I'm not 100% convinced I'm right on the ground. End of the round, Larry, with the body shots.
Once again, Cotto on the attack, standing his ground in the middle of the ring. Making it his territory.
All right, so we get ready to go to round number six. Miguel Cotto, and this is Sergio Martinez, the reigning champion, 2-1 favorite, and he's behind in this fight right now. I can be in an adrenaline rush that he wants to pick up the pace a little bit. see him again land that big left hook again as he did back in the first round.
Freddie calling for more combinations, more activity from Miguel in this round. Trying to string some more of the punches together.
And he's going to work his way in to do that, and he's trying to do exactly that. Martinez ties him up, as you see.
Himself.
Well, really has that look of determination, trying to land something big here. Now he's on the inside where he wants to be. Lunges with the left foot that time.
And you would think six rounds into a fight that we would have seen something from the champion, a significant shot, something that maybe would have rocked Cotto. So maybe say that shot was effective.
There hasn't been one, and the other factor is these legs still, they don't look great. It's very, very
interesting. In a close round, so who are you going to give it to? The guy running or the guy standing and trying to catch him?
Look at this. The close rounds, Cotto's definitely going to win boxing like this. Down to 20 seconds, that's going to be the case in this round, too. Hurries that one off, tries to get the left through there to no avail. Works to the inside. Open left hand, right hand. Started to walk away. He heard the pounding of the hammer. And for some reason, he must have thought it was a bell and started to walk away. Almost got caught, but it didn't affect him. Well, for the first half of the fight, it's been Cotto's fight. The three knockdowns in the first round. And here we are early in the first round, in this round here, that he's doing a nice job outboxing Martinez, and thought that Miguel did this most of the round. This guy's going to have to do something sensational now.
Yeah, he's got a long upward climb to get his way back in here. Oh, we have it, what, one round for Sergio. Some people, looking over social media briefly, have it a shutout through Cotto. But for Cotto through six.
Tell him Sergio to be first, but can he execute that? That's the big question. Here we go, second half of the fight. Should it go the distance, that is. This is round seven, Madison Square Garden, New York City. Miguel Cotto with the tattoo, Sergio Martinez, the reigning champ, 2-1 favorite, down three times in the first round. And Cotto won out of the first six rounds. He won five of them, plus the three-point round he had in the first round. So it's a tough hill to climb for Martinez, and he better start right now.
I think he had the idea from his corner that he's way behind, and that he's going to have to, at some point, deliver.
Look at this, knockouts after six rounds. Cotto 11 and 7 for Martinez. Has extended the left hand that time and got a piece of Cotto flesh. Nice stiff jab that time. Oh, actually it was the left hand down the middle, not the jab. This powerful shot. The left hand lead and got Cotto a couple of times. Hey, point for the past 15, 20 seconds, hasn't dominated the boxing. Misses with that wild left hook. Enos cut him good with that straight left hand down the middle. Glancing blow, that one carried away. Sergio Martinez is trying to force the fight a bit more now.
Buckled his knees with the right hand. That doesn't appear to be seriously hurt. Martinez is off and off balance, and he might get hit and not particularly hurt.
But in general, his knees just don't look terrific to me.
Now he's trying to be himself by lowering his fist, but Cotto is, with his quicker hands, has been making him keep his fist up, not in his normal punching position.
Now this is Martinez in the center of the ring now, and Cotto moving around on the outside, trying to get Martinez to pull and try to catch him off balance.
It's kind of a shame his knees aren't holding up, and you know, after the fight, Colonel, that will be, well, he wasn't at 100%, and that was evident from the beginning.
Larry, I saw you gave that round to Cotto, I gave it to Martinez.
I gave it to Cotto. It's apparent that Martinez now knows he has to attack, and we'll see if he can win the second half of this fight.
I gave Martinez the third round, and I gave him that seventh round, but that doesn't get him in the fight.
What are you doing? Be smart. You dictate the fight, right?
It's really slippery in the middle, Cotto saying he was trying to get the attention of the referee to let him know. They're soaking Sergio's shorts, and he's dripping as he comes out of the corner. It's creating a lot of water on the ring.
Yeah, well, the problem is that when the water drips out of the shorts and Martinez, it goes on that Tecate logo and the other logo that's right above the Tecate, and the water stays right there, and it is very slippery. And that can cause problems, and not only for Cotto, but for the knees of Sergio Martinez as well. Trying to revive the older guy by pouring the water down his trunks.
A sure sign that things are not going their way.
I've even seen him put ice down the trunks like that, and the guy's out in the middle of the ring, and the cubes are dropping on him. He's asking for somebody to get hurt. Not the case tonight. Martinez misses with his shots. Trying to move as best he can.
Trying to square up a little bit now to deliver something harder.
Freddy just told Cotto, stay in command. You're in command, stay there. Left hand lead again by Martinez was successful in one night occasion in the last round that I can recall. It's the jab now. Finding a home, missed with a big shot. Cotto caught him with a nice straight right hand of his own. At least it bounced the head back. Body shot back upstairs with a left hook. That was a glancing left hook. That one not planted like the ones back in the first round. Heads must have come together because Martinez indicating...
Cotto says, no, that was a punch.
But with the shorter guy in the southpaw on the right-handed fight, I would expect more of the head splashing. It hasn't been a problem to this point in the fight. Cotto staying outside, loads up the left, which doesn't quite catch him.
That right knee. Sergio Martinez, he keeps trying to flex it out when he gets a chance, kind of kick it out, shake it out, but it's definitely no power, no stability there. It's just a shame to see.
Look
right there gave out on him again.
Slipped again. And that's a case again, the third or fourth time in the fight where balance has been a problem for him. Straight right hand, landed by Cotto. Again, Martinez is busy enough, but Cotto won the round, in my opinion. Not a lot done, but enough to win the round. Replays from the eighth round. Cotto lands the heavier blow there. That's one of the better shots of the round. And we'll show you the slip. See again, off balance, and the knee kind of buckles underneath again. But Cotto in the eighth round, more successful landing heavier blows. I got him up front 78-71. With four rounds to go, Miguel Cotto, who started a house of fire in the first round, knocking Sergio Martinez down three times.
Sergio comes out like he's, I know I gotta make something happen. Cotto hits him upside the head and takes immediate control back.
Left hook, a glancing blow that time. Martinez, you know, Christina, a couple rounds ago, maybe three rounds ago, you mentioned I haven't seen anything really land flush by Martinez, and nothing is
happening. Right hand, and that landed square on Martinez.
It's one of the best solid punches that Cotto's landed going back to the early stages of this fight. And I think it had an effect on Martinez because he just got hit with an uppercut. His Cotto now senses that he might have him there. Sergio hangs on. The hands are starting to slide down just a bit. Well, let's see if Cotto can capitalize on two solid shots that he's landed.
Oh, there's another left, right.
And that right hand down the middle. That's the one you want to land on the southpaw. Beautiful low blow by Martinez there. But Cotto's got some heavy shots. And left hook got him. And he may have him again. His legs have really loosened the knees again in a load of time. A minute and a half. The crowd senses Cotto is in total command right here. And let's see if he is. He lands another big left hook. Cotto patient enough. He's not going crazy here. Just trying to line this guy up with some solid shots. Martinez, who, as Larry said, came out with the balance of forethought and hasn't been able to deliver. It's that awkward right hand that he throws, and it was countered by a right hand by Martinez, by Cotto. Nice straight right hand again, and that brought Martinez down on his heels. Martinez now is fighting on instinct.
Cotto is fighting really smart.
Very smart.
He's not giving him a chance to land one of those punches that come from who knows where. He's defending himself. He's being on the attack when he sees the opportunity and defending himself between those opportunities.
And he should get credit. I mean, I don't...
Oh, straight left hand! Back of the knees. He's going to call that a knockdown. He said the knee hit the canvas. So he's going to call it a knockdown. Is that the taking the standing eight count? Anyway, he got a 6-7-8. Now, we'll have the advantage of seeing him hit that knee, but the referee saw that knee touch, and that takes him totally out of the fight.
I don't think it touched
him. I don't think it touched either, but we will see in the replay. The referee thought it touched him, and if he thought it touched, let's see. He got him with a flush shot. Let's see if the knee does touch. Bang. No.
Nope.
It doesn't. Referee, for some reason, thought that knee touched, but it doesn't make any difference. It's still scored because nobody, in terms of the judges, has the advantage of what we have, and that's the replay. Be 100% sure. I questioned in the beginning, but there's no question now. That That's another 10-8 round. Take another look at it.
Point, you mentioned Cotto doing everything right, and if this fight ends up going the distance and Cotto wins this decision, hopefully he gets credit for that, and it's not just, well, you just faced Sergio at 100%.
Well, you know, it's going to be a part of the narrative.
Absolutely.
Older engine fighter, he can't come out. The fight is over. We have a new middleweight champion.
Miguel Cotto has done it after 9 rounds. The former champion cannot continue. And Miguel Cotto is the new WBC middleweight champion of the world.
What a performance by Miguel Cotto. Whatever the condition of Martinez, who has been a valiant fighter throughout his career, he was older, he was damaged goods, but Cotto got him in the first round before anybody could see any evidence of that. And went on from there to win which I'm sure will be a famous victory for him, no matter what happens in the rest of his career.
Oh, no matter what is said about the aging champion. A lot of great fighters over the years beat aging champions. Larry Holmes.
Older man couldn't be a great
younger
smaller man tonight. Cotto was as good as he has ever been under the circumstances.
Absolutely. He came, he saw, he down. So a tremendous victory.